Alright, so this is a $500 gaming PC featured in the RTX 2060. So if you're a big fan of this GPU, you want to get this GPU on a budget build, this is the one for you based on brand new parts that's got a good upgrade path. So let's get to the benchmarks. And first we got Hogwarts Legacy, and as I told you before, you're gonna get 60 FPS at 1080p medium and high settings. Call of Duty Warzone 2, and you will get around 100 to 110 FPS at 1080p competitive settings. Now Warzone keeps getting more and more optimized for the budget systems. Red Dead Redemption 2, and at 1080p ultra settings, you're getting yourself around 60 FPS. And the last game that we have, which is Cyberpunk 2077, at 1080p high to ultra settings, you'll find yourself getting around 60 frames per second. Now the CPU, we're looking at the AMD Ryzen 5 4500. Now this is a 6-core 12-threaded CPU that goes for $80 that supports our board out of the box, so you don't need any BIOS updates. This CPU is kind of comparable to the Ryzen 5 3600, but not as fast as it when it comes to the gaming performance, but nevertheless it will not bottleneck our GPU, and it's got a good upgrade path, and this is the best budget CPU under $100 right now in my opinion, because there isn't a lot of options. As for the board, we're looking at the A520M-S2A board, or any A520M board that you can find in stock, because they usually go out of stock, but any of the boards that you can find on Amazon supports this CPU out of the box. You don't need any BIOS updates, and it will be okay with something like a 5700X, 5800X, or even a 5800X3D in the future. So it's got all the bells and whistles you need, PCIe Gen 4 or 4.0. The RAM, we're looking at 16 gigs to 8 gigabytes 6 of DDR4 3200 MHz RAM at $35. This is more than enough for gaming. As for now, you know, you can also upgrade to 32 gigs in the future if you'd like to, but as for what it is, a budget PC that, you know, gets the job done. And the SSD, we're looking at 512 gigabyte M.2 SSD that goes for $23. It supports our board, you know. A 512 gig seems to be a decent amount of space, so you're not gonna have any problems here or there, you know. And fast boot up times, of course, loading speeds, and there's no problem at all. As for the GPU, we're looking at the RTX 2060 that you can get from Amazon. I believe the brand name called Pelden or something like that. This one goes for $225 after a coupon code added. So the RTX 2060 complements this PC really good. You can also go with an ARC 6600 if you want to. You're actually getting more performance and saving a lot of money. There is a video where it kind of compared to the Ryzen 5 3600 or the 5600 to this CPU with the ARC 6600, and you wouldn't find any difference in terms of performance, but there's a big performance difference between the RTX 2060 and the ARC 6600. But hey, you're an Nvidia fan, you want an RTX 2060 brand new, this is the one for you. As for the case, we're looking at the Big Gears case that usually goes for $40, sometimes $45. This case gets the job done, got really good airflows, got RGB bling in the front, you know. So yeah, really good case. You don't need that much of a, you know, crazy good airflow. This PC doesn't consume a lot of power or heat anyways. And the power supply, we're looking at the trusty Enermax Cyberon 500 watt 80 plus bronze certified power supply. The RTX 2060 is kind of, you know, GPU efficient, you know, or an efficient one. So as the ARC 6600, so any GPU of the two GPUs, you know, will get the job done, and the 500 watts will handle it with ease. So yeah, that's been it. If you like it, press on that like button. If you want to see more videos, like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.